All right, and welcome back. Let's continue to talk to the people who have got to know the late Ahmed Kathrada. And on the line now, we're joined by a human rights activist and the former Constitutional Court Judge Albie Sachs. Mr. Sachs, it's a very, very, very good morning to you and welcome to Morning Live.
Good morning. You can call me Judge Albie.
Thank you so much, Judge. Your memories, fond memories, of course, of the late Ahmed Kathrada.
Yes, very, very, very strong. I remember as a law student in the 1950s, I'm studying at Cape Town, I'm living in Cape Town, but I used to love going to Joburg because that's where it was at. And Calvert House in Johannesburg near the center, Ahmed Kathrada, but we always called him Kathy, was the kind of centerpiece of a youth movement, the Transvaal Indian Youth Congress. And if I wanted inspiration, if I wanted fun, if I wanted fire, that was the place to go to.
All right. He was one of the human rights activists, of course, and you as well. What do you think he has left for us as South Africans in
you
terms
know,
of human rights?
This term human rights activist doesn't really convey it. We were freedom fighters. We were revolutionaries. We wanted to change the world. We wanted to destroy apartheid. And there was a kind of an energy there that was very powerful, and it was warm, and it was humane. And you know what strikes me so much about Kathy? In those days, he had a big mop of hair. Now we think of him as this guy with just thin wisps of hair. And now he's so thoughtful and considered. Then he was passionate and fiery. But at the center, at his heart, was a strong beating heart of a revolutionary who wanted freedom, who wanted justice, who invested his life in that. And we were captivated by it and wanted to be part of it. And it was in places like Calvert House that our non-racialism in South Africa was really cemented, more between African and Indian combatants against apartheid than African black and white. But it was done with joy and enthusiasm. And looking back on Kathrada's life, what amazes me so much is in those days he didn't have money for university, he didn't follow that track. We had people like Ismail Mohammed from similar backgrounds who went to university, became Chief Justice. Kathy, I think, left school before matriculation, but who ended up producing the greatest books on Robben Island, the most thoughtful about literature. There was something kind of profound in his soul and his style that linked up the commitment of a revolutionary freedom fighter with deep, deep, deep humanity. And that's why I think he's so missed now. We miss his smile and that warmth and that thoughtfulness and that intense, deep humanity and integrity. It was never about money or jobs or power. He was never a maneuverer. That freedom-fighting passion really beated powerfully in his heart.
Yeah, he was one of the greatest leaders, of course. But what do you think the current leaders should take from Uncle Kathy?
Well, I think everybody, not only the leaders, but young people, old, can take from him that commitment, that passion, that sense of humor, that love for humanity. A leader doesn't have to be a boss, doesn't have to be a smart ass. A leader doesn't have to be a maneuverer, manipulator. A leader can be somebody who leads with his heart, with his soul, with his spirit, with his thoughtfulness. And that the non-racialism in him was profound. It wasn't just a slogan or a statement. It was seeing the human being inside every person. And you've got to feel the human being inside yourself and not be avaricious and ambitious. But exude that kind of affection for others, willingness to listen to others, and creativity and thoughtfulness. It's no accident that at the funeral of Mandela, the one voice that came out the strongest and the most beautifully and the purest, that had the most affection when hundreds of millions of people throughout the world were listening, was the voice of Ahmed Kathrada. It wasn't routine. It wasn't just repeating in a monotonous way slogans from the struggle. It was speaking as one revolutionary combatant and fighter in honor of another Nelson Mandela.
All right. Judge Sachs, thank you so much for talking to us this morning.
Thank you.
Thank you very much indeed. Well, that's the former Constitutional Court Judge LB Sex talking to us about his fond memories of the late Ahmed Kathrada. You can join in the conversation at Morning Live SABC. Talk to us about how do you remember him, your fond memories of him, and of course you can also take the moment to convey your sincere condolences to the families, friends, of course, and the comrades of the late Uncle Kathy. Let's quickly take a break here on Morning Live. The show continues after this.
Tula sizwe ma,